Every man, driver nation, what is going on? You know what time it is? It's time to showcase a new vehicle, and this one is in Snowflake White Pearl Mica. Bam! Recognize that? That is a 2017 Mazda CX-9 all-wheel drive. Now, this vehicle made its world debut in 2006. 2016, they redesigned it. And here we are, 2017, and I like the way this looks. We're gonna do what we did last time. One take. Nothing overproduced, nothing re-edited. No disrespect to the camera crews out there who have an editor, videographer, talent person, when they have to reset up their shots and do different angles and three or four different cameras. One take for you guys, because you are the Everyman Driver Nation. Your time is important. Let's do this right now. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna show you how smart I am, how good I am with my memory. 2.5 liter, four cylinder, six speed automatic transmission. Now, 227 horsepower, 310 pound feet of torque. That's with regular gas. 250 horsepower if you put premium in it. So I'm showing you right here, all wheel drive. This comes in four trim levels: Sport, Touring, Grand Touring, and Signature. We have the Grand Touring here. Now, each of those is available in front wheel and all wheel drive, except the Signature, which we don't have. Signature is only all wheel drive. And check out these wheels, 20 inch alloys. You get 18s on the lowest trim level, but we don't have the low trim level because we are ballers. We are the Everyman Driver Nation. I like the way this front end looks. SkyActiv technology. Got a backup camera right there. There's also the lift gate. Let's do that right now. Go ahead and do it. Now we can open it up right here. I'll go ahead and do that. Now this is below average. Behind this back row of seats, about 14 cubic feet of volume. You fold them down, which I've got one right there down, about 37-ish. Fold those down, looking at 70 plus cubic feet of volume. And that is below average for this three row, seven passenger SUV class. Can you believe it? They call this a midsize crossover SUV. I'm gonna use the force here. Hold that. Yes, Obi-Wan. Let's go inside. This just arrived. That's why we call it just arrived. There we go. I don't like this sun glare. It's tough. All right, all right, all right. Push button. What else can I tell you about the overview here inside the cabin? Heated seats. Love that. Now, as you've heard in my other Mazda reviews, this is touchscreen when the car is parked. Okay? When we get it in drive, we're driving around, we gotta use this dial down here. Not a big deal. I think it's better to have your hands down here versus stretching out up there, my opinion. Now you have a 7 and 8 inch touchscreen available, depends on which trim level you go with. I don't think you can see it here, but I'll see if I can zoom in on my one take video here. There it is, heads up display. That's how fast I'm going right now. Booyah. I slipped it in there. Instrument cluster, decent there. You've got some of your safety options to the left here. There's one more trunk release. You've got lane departure warning, which is right there. You got blind spot detection right there. Traction control, this parking sensor here on the left-hand side. Usual. Speaking of usual and suspects, Kevin Spacey, here's where you have adaptive cruise control. Cruise control in general, Bluetooth technology, pick up the phone, hang it up. I forget what this part is here, but that's what I have the car for, so I can do a review. All right. Sport mode, six speed automatic transmission. Let's go ahead and put it in reverse. I'll show you the reverse. Zoom in. There's my recycling can. So if you look over there, see if that focuses or not. It'll let you know where the danger is coming, if there's something coming in your blind spot. All right, can't do it right there. So that's what, and these lane lines, I guess they don't turn. Sometimes these lane lines will turn as the car turns with you, but not in this case. Put it back into drive. Now, you do have a manual mode, so if you want to shift over while you're driving, you can do that because there are no paddle shifters on this car. Automatic park brake, I like this. Audio sources, home button, navigation. Yeah. Oh, in here, let's see what we got. Oh, yep, two USB ports, compartment, and let's see, flip this around. You do have a single moonroof as opposed to two of them. Come on, I want two of them. What else? We got some good leather in here. Leather shift knob. Turn this bad boy off. Let's go to the bank. All right, three rows. There's your middle row. And what's nice about this one, as I remember, you have the option down here to slide it. And that sliding helps you gain access back here. See how that works? Of course you do. And there's 50-50 split back there. This is a 60-40 split in the middle row. Let's see if I can configure all this with one hand. All right, so there's your back seat. Let's bring my 5'11 frame in here. Show you what the leg room looks like. Again, I can slide, got some seat travel here, so it's gonna help out or make it worse. Ta-da! Headroom, it's pretty impressive. Look at this, not quite there. Headroom is good for guys 5'11, clearly an indent in ceiling. Can you see this? See how that goes? Nice curves. Didn't mean to make that look dirty. Old blind candle here, there's four of them. Yes, yes, yes. Another angle of the cabin area. Okay. Oh, climate controls back here for the Grand Touring. If you got the Signature and that's the highest trim level, you can get a lot more luxury in the car, but this is pretty luxurious as it is. I know for a fact that the starting price is 31 and a half for the CX-9. This one is in the low 40s. Last word I got, and fold down armrest here. Cool. What else we got? That. Oh, more USB ports. See how smart that is? Because they know, Mazda knows, people have their phones, they want to keep them charged up. Fuel economy. Now there's the front wheel and all-wheel drive. All right, Dave, dip into your memory palace. 22 city, 28 highway in the all-wheel drive. We have the front-wheel drive. All-wheel drive is 21 city, 27 highway. So I'll have to give it a drive and figure out what the numbers are for me. Kind of tough because look at this. It's been really hard this winter. I know, first world problems. First car YouTuber problems. It's hard to get some good fuel economy numbers when our weather has been crappy. So I'll do what I can. I don't think I'll have time this week to go off-road, but I did do an off-road review in the 2016 version of this car. So there you go. Any questions, comments, concerns, queries, contemplations, put them in. I went alliteration overboard. Put them in the comment section below and let me know what you think. If you haven't watched before, it's your first time visiting, thanks for visiting. Click that subscribe button. I'm doing some weird, wild, wacky stuff. There I went again with my channel. Unconventional in terms of how I do things at times. What else? What else you care about? Zoom, zoom, driving matters, hashtag. There you go. Oh, Everyman Drivers on Instagram. Follow me there. I'm always around. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching this Just Arrived video of the 2017 Mazda CX-9. Adios. I'm out. Oh, key drop. I think I just invented that. I did. No mic drop. Here, one more time, just for those kids at home. Key drop.